If you've heard about the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, you've probably heard that Jerusalem is the center of the conflict, but there's another city known for being even more intense for Jews and Arabs. This is Hebron. Home to 250,000 Palestinians and 800 Jews. A city divided into two areas. Over there, H1, and right here, H2, that were mutually agreed on by Palestinians and Israelis as part of the Hebron Protocols in 1997. H1 is under full Palestinian civil and military control. H2, 20% of Hebron, is under Israeli military control and only 3% inhabited by Jews. Hebron is also home to the Cave of the Patriarchs, where the forefathers of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam are believed to be buried. And it's also the second holiest site in the Jewish faith. Today, it's divided into a synagogue on one side and a mosque on the other. Following numerous incidents of violence between Arabs and Jews, with both sides committing awful acts of terror. Sadly, there are many divisions in Hebron due to violence. Jews and non-Muslims aren't permitted to visit the Cave of the Patriarchs on certain days of the week, and Muslims are forbidden on some of the days which Jews are permitted. Jews are also forbidden from entering H1 due to dozens of terror attacks against Jews by Palestinians from Hebron. And Arabs have been restricted from El Shuhada Street following in a shocking attack in which a Jewish terrorist shot 29 Muslim worshippers and injured 125 in the Cave of the Patriarchs. These streets opened up temporarily to Palestinians following the Hebron Protocol until the violence on the Palestinian side in the Second Intifada triggered a shutdown again. So why are the restrictions in Hebron so intense, unlike anywhere else in Israel or the West Bank? Because Hebron is known for having the worst extremists on both sides. Extremist minority, but very dominant. Meaning that preventing violence is a top priority for the leaders of both sides, and here is why. Tens of thousands of Palestinians from Hebron work in Israel every day. Of the 87,000 Palestinians who work in Israel, thousands are from Hebron. Hebron also accounts for 40% of Palestinian GDP and one-third of all Palestinians exports. Meaning if there's a rise in terrorism and a reduction in permits and in exports due to a war, Hebron suffers directly. This occurred in 2015 with a wave of 9 terror attacks in 13 days committed by Palestinians from Hebron. And Hebron is even known for being a stronghold for the terrorist organization Hamas. The reality is, innocent people on both sides are harmed when terrorism occurs. The final status of Hebron will have to be decided by the leaders of both sides. But by reducing violence and enhancing economic opportunities, Israelis and Palestinians may be able to find a way forward in this hotly contested historical city.